It has been a year and a half since Intel announced the Thunderbolt 4, and Apple finally releases Thunderbolt 4 cable after the spring event. It can be divided into 1.8 meters and 3 meters and priced at $159 and $129 respectively. The 3 meters is still unavailable, so we got the 1.8 meters and took it apart to check why it can be so expensive. The package continues Apple's design, and Mac Studio and Studio Display are on the back. The side sticker shows it's compatible with USB-C Thunderbolt and USB devices. Model is A2734, made in China. Open the box, it contains the cable and manuals inside. The Thunderbolt 4 cable is similar to the Thunderbolt 3 cable we've taken apart. You can click the upper right corner to take a look. It's very thick and adopts black braided design that coils without tangling. Like the previous generation, there is no protective sleeve between the cable and the connector. Take a closer look at the details of this cable. The connector is pretty long with the Thunderbolt logo on it. We cannot tell if it's Thunderbolt 3 or 4. The USB-C connector adopts a full pin design. The length of this cable is 1.8 meters, and the diameter is about 5 millimeters. Weight is about 77 grams. The charger led power ZKM001C shows it can support 20 volts, 5 amp, 100 watts, and up to 40 gigabits per second. Firstly, let's cut it off. It's a coaxial cable, and there are 19 wires inside. This is the woven layer, which is dustproof and waterproof. Remove it, and then here is the black TPE, pretty smooth. Cut off the TPE, and the shielding layer is under it. After that, we can see the tin foil layer for shielding. And the third layer of shielding is in here. Finally, we can see those 19 wires in different colors, which are used for data transmission and power supply separately. Let's separate and introduce them one by one. Those 5 red wires and a purple wire are used for positive power supply, and it's made of tinned copper wire. The orange, red, green, and blue wires adopt coaxial design. And the first layer is plastic insulating layer, and the copper foil is under it. The most internal wires are plated with silver and wrapped with a pure copper shielding plated with silver. And then the blue wire is CC wire, the yellow one is VCON wire, and the black one is SBU wire. Another 2 green wires with white plastic are used for USB 2.0 transmission. This one is white wire with red plastic. Finally, there are 2 bare wires. Next, let's try to open the connector. Since it's Apple, we have to use the cutting machine to open it. Try to remove the black plastic. And the PCB is protected by brass sleeve. And there are 2 circles of dense solder joints on it, which can fix the connector and the junction. And it's marked with BC1762 here. The other side is C198020. After removing the brass sleeve, we can see the small PCBs inside. Both ends are exactly the same. The front and back sides are different, and there are lots of different chips. 4 pairs of differential signal wires are soldered side by side, and the junction is protected by glue. Flip to the back, the power supply wires and step-down circuit are soldered on the back. Next, let's introduce those components one by one. The largest one is Intel's Thunderbolt ReTimer chip, model is JHL7040. It's used for signal reconstruction and can reduce signal jitter. This tiny shiny chip is marked with 3CD. This is crystal oscillator marked with T250. Another large chip on the back comes from Infineon CYPDC1186, a marker chip. This one comes from MPS marked with HU. We presumed is a step-down chip. The power converter IC is marked with GAYG. And finally, here is the on-semiconductor diode. Let's take a close look at the inside of the connector. There are a total of 24 pins, and each pin is plated with gold, which can be more durable. You can pause to see what they correspond to. You can also check what their functions are. Well, that's all components of this Thunderbolt 4 Pro cable. After taking apart, we can see why this cable is so expensive. Not only because the brand is Apple, but because its quality is pretty good. Multiple layers of shielding per wire can reduce interference, and the Intel Thunderbolt chip can ensure stable and reliable signal transmission. For most customers, this high standard cable is a bit redundant. But for creators who need the performance of this cable, it might be the best option right now. Okay, that's all for today's video. You can also click the corners to view other Teardown videos about Apple and cable. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. I'll catch you guys in the next video.